Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Audrey, and today I'm going to be doing a Lululemon haul and review of some of my recent purchases. This video, I'm going to be covering 8 new items that Lululemon has come out with, including some really popular ones that I was just very excited to see them come out with. Even one that I think is just absolutely brilliant in product design. I did just recently do another Lululemon video. In that video, there are items like this, the halter tank, and I go into depth of what my thoughts are, which obviously I love it since I'm wearing it. Crop scuba hoodie, and some other really popular items that I encourage you to check out. I have that linked down below. The way that I like to do my haul videos is just kind of get right into it and give you all of the information that you're wanting and to not make you watch the entire video if you don't want to. So I'm going to put on the screen coming up the item that I'm going to be covering and the time stamp that you can just skip ahead to if that's the one that you're only wanting to watch. I just hope that you find some value in this, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And also subscribe to my channel for more of these haul videos. And also I have a bunch of really awesome workouts that you can try. Okay, so here are all of the items that I will be showing you today. First up, we have the Align dress. And this is the item that I think is very genius in product design. So stay tuned. The Align bodysuit in a 6-inch length. The Crossback Nulu Yoga bodysuit in a 25-inch. The Everlux asymmetrical tennis tank top. The Align asymmetrical bra in a C to D cup. The Hold Tight crop shirt. Ribbed soft stream crop tank. And lastly, the hood light jacket. Every single item that you see in today's video is going to be linked down below in the description. And I would be very grateful if you shop from those links, because I do get a small percentage of that purchase. So please shop from that. It's a very easy way to just give a thank you for putting this video together. And it's easy and free for you to do. And I would just appreciate it so much. Now we will get into the haul video, which I think has some of my most favorite items that I've ever tried from Lululemon to date. So get ready. So first up, we have the Align dress in flush pink. And as I stated, this is just such a smart idea and concept that I have not seen before. So I'm not sure if Lulu is the first one to think of it. So props to them. But what I love about this dress is that it has a 4-inch booty short liner on the inside. So you can see right here, these are the shorts on the inside, and they are the same color as the dress itself. There's pockets on the inside of these shorts, which is great because it's hidden. And then the genius part is that in the back, it's an open back waistband. Why this is so brilliant is because I don't know if you're like me, but it gets a little bit awkward in the bathroom stall when you have to take off your entire outfit to go to the bathroom. And this is smart because you can just pull down from that open back waistband and just go pee, or whatever you're trying to do. I'm gonna show in the try on portion, I'll put a pair of Align shorts underneath it so that I can show you the contrasting colors and you can see exactly how that would work. So that feature alone makes this very worth it, in my opinion. I think that this is a great staple. But that feature alone is what makes this a 10 out of 10, 100% recommend purchase. I think that this is something that you can wear casually going to lunch or dinner with some friends, or even you could wear it to tennis or golf. So I really like when my Lulu items that I get are multi-purpose items, because it makes me feel like I'm getting a little bit more out of the value. On top of being incredibly functional, it's also a very cute and flattering cut. It has the same exact cut as a normal Align tank, and it has the same scoop back that a tank has. Now I am 5'10", so you'll see where this dress hits me on my legs, but I personally find that it's the perfect length for me. It's not too short, it's not too long. I did get this in a size 8 because this was the only one that they had in store. I actually really like the fit, and I think that a size 8 is a very comfortable fit for me. Normally in the tanks, I wear a size 6, but I do size up to an 8 if I want it to be a little bit less busty. So I would recommend to stay true to size with whatever you order your Align tank in. So next we have the Align bodysuit in a 6-inch length. I've actually refrained from buying a bodysuit from Lululemon up until this point, which this haul video actually has two, including this one. And I have to say that I'm happy I waited until they came out with the 6-inch length. All of my Align shorts are 6 inches, and I know that they had the 8-inch, and I could have easily have just hemmed it to a 6-inch, but I just have been waiting for a perfect fit, and I think this is the one. This is incredibly flattering. I think that where the waistband hits is just perfect, and it has the same details similar to the Align dress as a normal Align tank top, with the same cut in the front and a scoop back like this. You can also see that it has the same cut that the Align shorts and Align leggings are known to have, which is sort of that V cut in the back, and that's what gives it a little extra emphasis on the peach and makes it so flattering. As mentioned in the review for the Align dress, I can wear a size 6 or a size 8 in my Align tank. However, in my Align shorts, I like a size 6, and in my Align leggings, I like a size 4. So it really varies quite a bit, but I got this bodysuit in a size 6, and I think that that was my perfect fit. It feels like it's not overly compressive, but it does feel like it holds me in a little bit. So I do like the size 6 fit on this versus a size 8. This is the Crossback Nulu Yoga Bodysuit in a 25-inch length. This bodysuit is a low-impact bodysuit, which you can tell right away given the straps alone. So it is a very thin spaghetti strap, which it's not as thick as the Align strap, which makes it just not able to hold up with high-impact activities, which is absolutely fine. I think that this is great for just lounging in, again, wearing casually or wearing to yoga or Pilates, something just more low impact. The details of this bodysuit are just very delicate in my opinion. I think that the scoop front is just very sweet, and the open back is incredibly flattering and perfect for me because I live in Arizona, so I like a little airflow. I really like where the stitching is on this bodysuit. It's a little bit higher up than on the Align bodysuit, and I'll show you what the back looks like. So in the back, it doesn't quite have that same V cutout that Align shorts and Align leggings have, similar to the Align bodysuit. It does not have that. This is just more of a straight back seam. It has a little bit of a curve, but not that traditional V one that we're used to. And it technically has that open waistband feature to where maybe you could pull it down if you're going to the bathroom. I did try it, and since it's a higher up fit, it's a little bit harder to get it past my butt to feel confident in going to the bathroom. So maybe you could figure that out. But personally for me, I am going to have to take off the entire thing to go to the restroom. So sizing wise, I got this in a size 6, similar to the Align bodysuit, because once again, in my leggings, I like to wear a size 4 generally, but my top half is definitely not a size 4. So I opted for meeting in the middle and doing a size 6. And it seemed to be just the best fit. I feel like if I size down, it would be way too tight. If I size up, it'd be way too loose in the back and the bottom half. So for this, I would say if you're in between like a 4, like I am in leggings, and a 6 or 8 in a top, I would definitely go in between whatever those sizes are. And that should be your perfect fit. Now we have the Everlux Asymmetrical Tennis Tank Top. When I saw this style, I got really excited because I love that it's a little bit different and more unique than just a standard tank. It gives off that asymmetrical look, obviously, with the thicker strap over here, and it has the extra support of this thin strap on the left side. It is a medium support, and it has a built-in bra. This is what the back of it looks like, so it has a sort of racer back style. It is a cropped length, but I find that it hits perfectly with high-waisted leggings or shorts. Another thing that I want to mention with this top is that it has almost 5 stars with reviews, which is actually very rare for Lululemon items, I find. So it has 4.9 stars, and a lot of people really love the coverage, feel like it holds up during their workouts, including HIIT workouts. So I think that this is a great staple item that I recommend. And I got this in a size 6, and I definitely think that it is true to size. If you're in between, I would size up. This is the ribbed cropped soft shrink tank top in the color flush pink. If you can't tell, I love this color of pink. I think it is just the most beautiful pastel baby pink color. I got this shirt in a size 6, and I think that is the perfect fit for me. Could I have sized down to a 4? Yes, but I think it would have been a little bit more difficult to put on, and it maybe would have been a little bit too tight in the armpit area. I absolutely would not size up in this tank, because then it would just be a little bit too loose. So stick true to size. If anything, I would size down. The one thing that I noticed right away when I saw this item pop up was the model picture. And you could see that it was a little bit loose up here in the straps. And now that I've gotten this and tried it on, it is clear to me that the reason why is because this top really doesn't have any stretch at all. I feel like the style and cut of this top is very similar to the Power Pivot top. It has, you can wear it this way with a scoop front and a V-neck in the back, or wear the V-neck in the front and have it have a higher back. I, again, love when with Lululemon items, I just have multiple ways I can wear something, because again, it justifies the price a little bit better to me. Generally on soft stream products on Lululemon, you'll see a lot of reviews talking about water stains. They actually even acknowledge this on the product tag itself, saying that if you have a water drop stain, just put it a gentle wash or hand wash it and it will come out. I actually have never had an issue with it permanently staining. I've never even noticed water drop stains, and I have this sort of pink color. I think it's called Pink Mist from a few years back, and I have never had an issue with staining. And I even have the white opal soft stream top, and I also don't have an issue with staining. So don't let those comments necessarily deter you from buying anything soft stream. It's a very unique type of fabric, and I do highly recommend it. This top just really isn't that stretchy. So when you're putting it on, anticipate that, because I didn't anticipate that. And I thought that it was gonna fit a little funky, but once it's on, I think it's just a very cute and flattering fit. Now we have the Align Asymmetrical Bra in a C to D cup. And this is in the color flush pink again, and it's a size 6. I personally am a very big fan of Lululemon trying out asymmetrical styles. I love that it is the long line length. I have the other asymmetrical bra that they came out with earlier this year. That is a shorter length about right there. And while I do like that, I always wish that they had a long line version of that. And this was the answer to that desire. Now they do have this style of sports bra in an A to B size cup and a C to D, which is this. I like getting the C to D style of these sort of sports bras because I like having pads and having a little bit more support. The A to B cup does not have any padding. So that's kind of the big difference between that, other than also coverage. I feel like this has a lot more coverage than obviously an A to B cup sports bra would. I'll show you what the back of it looks like right here. It's very simple in the cut, but I do like that it has a thicker strap for the one shoulder design. I think that that is what actually keeps it up really nicely. As far as sizing goes, I got this in a size 6, and that is my perfect size. I would not size down or size up. In the normal traditional line bra, the waistband or the band right here can be a little bit tight, and so I actually have sized up to a size 8 before. For whatever reason, this band right here is not as tight. I would say to stay true to size, and if you're in between sizes, I would size up, but I think that whatever your true size is would be your perfect fit. Now we have the whole tight cropped short sleeve top, and out of all items in my haul video today, this one feels like it is very overpriced for what it is. So the price is $58, and it's essentially just a very plain crop top. I would personally wait for this to go to the We Made Too Much just to get a little bit of a discount on it, because at $60, I don't think that it's worth that. However, ignoring the price tag of this shirt, is it very cute? Yes, absolutely. Do I love the cut of it? Yes. Is it very comfortable? Yes. So if it's something that you can justify with the price tag, definitely go ahead and grab this top. The fabric of the whole tight shirts are just beyond heavenly. I have the whole tight short sleeve long version of the shirt, and then I also have the long sleeve shirt. So I was really excited to see that they had a cropped version. since those tops are a little bit long for my style. I love a good crop top. And I actually really like that it is not just a plain straight cut in the front. It actually scoops down a little bit in the front and in the back. You'll notice when I try this on that the white is very see-through, so you will see whatever sports bra you have underneath. But they also do have other colors. They have black, and I think they have a pink color. So check them out down below at the link. Also, for the sizing, this is a size 6. I did try it in a size 4, and it fit, but it was a little bit too tight. This fabric itself, though, will never be like a constricting tight feel because it is just so stretchy. But I did like it sitting on my skin a little bit looser and just having a little more comfort overall. And I felt like with the white color, it wasn't as see-through because it wasn't pulling as much, if that makes sense. Last but not least, we have the hood-like jacket in the color Pink Clay, and it is a size 2. If you've watched this review up until this point, you're gonna hear size 2 and be like, what the heck? That's not even remotely close to any of the other sizes that you've gotten in this video, and you're right. Normally, I do not ever order a size 2, or can I fit in it? However, I do find with some of the Lululemon jackets, they're a little bit oversized, and so I actually do most of the time size down to a size 4 for my true size 6. But I felt like in this jacket, a size 2 looked a little bit more flattering on me. So when you go to order this jacket, I would definitely at least order a size down, if not 2 sizes. As far as some of the features go, it obviously has a hood, given the name. And the fabric is called Glide, so it is water repellent. It's not 100% water resistant, so you will eventually get pretty wet if you're standing out in soaking rain. However, if you're someone like me who lives in a warmer climate, this is a great jacket to put on when there is a light drizzle in the summer, or even just for summer nights when it starts to get a little bit chilly because it is not very warm. A couple more features that I want to point out on the jacket. It does have pockets on both sides, and it is cinchable on the bottom, so you can customize the fit and make it feel a little bit tighter around your waist. You can pack this up easily into the hood of the jacket. So inside the hood, there is this Lululemon strap. This is what you'll use to carry it over your shoulder once you put it into the hood. To give you a clear view of what exactly this looks like. So from the back, here it is. It has a flap in the middle, and then in the front, the 2 large pockets. I'm gonna try to do this on camera, and I'll speed it up a little bit so you don't see the struggle entirely, but I'm gonna try to see how easy it is to actually pack this jacket up. Ta-da! I don't know if this is entirely how it looked like on the model, but it is packed up and easy to carry. So 10 out of 10. Close up this video. I just want to say again, thank you for taking the time to watch this. And also don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you liked it or found something of value from this video. I hope I helped you decide in whether you wanted to buy something or maybe if it's something that you actually realize that you want to hold off on. I know that I have personally watched many different haul videos that have helped me determine if something was actually worth it. So I can only hope that someone felt that way about mine. As with my other haul videos, I like to summarize which items I felt were really good buys and worth the price, and ones that I would maybe hold off to get on We Made Too Much. My favorite purchases from this haul was the Align dress. I just think as far as functionality goes, it's a 10 out of 10. And it's, again, something that you can wear for multiple occasions. It's also an item that I don't ever really see going to We Made Too Much because it is so popular. Many of these sizes are actually still sold out, but I would, if you're trying to save up for something and you were to get one item, I would really get the Align dress. It also feels like you're getting a sort of 2-for-1 deal with the dress itself. And I feel that way about actually both of the onesies too. I feel like we're getting a top, a bottom, and even in the dress, an extra Align shorts in the mix. So it feels a little bit more justified, as some of the leggings can even cost what the entire bodysuit or onesie costs. Which leads me to the other ones that I think are really good must-buys, and that is the Align onesie, another staple that can be casual or for working out. And I did really like the cross-back Nulu bodysuit. I felt like it was a very comfortable and flattering fit. So that leaves the other four items in this haul as the items that I think that you could wait to grab on We Made Too Much, simply from the fact that I think that they would eventually get there because the price is pretty high for what they are. Whew, okay, I think that concludes this haul video. Every time I do one of these, I try to be a little bit better and take the feedback that you guys give me into the next one. So if there's anything that you wish I did better in this, please comment down below. And I just hope that you enjoyed it.